Okay. So yesterday we looked until CSV imports. So now let's continue further. I got an email from Funny. So Funny, you asked for credentials. I can't provide the credentials. You need to ask whoever joined you into this meeting. So ask these guys, Narsimha or someone. They let you know whom to contact for credentials. And regarding the recordings, yeah, they're huge recordings. So, and I even need to edit some of the recordings. So it'll take some time. I'll do it over this weekend, and then I'll send it to you all. I'll share it to you all. I'll place them in my Google Drive and share it to you all. And regarding going slow, Funny, I'm trying my best to go slow. So once you get the recordings, once you go through them, you'll understand. I'm not trying to rush fast, actually. In the last training batch, I finished admin in 3 days. So now here we are taking almost a week and week or so. So I'm trying to go as slow as I can. Once you get the recordings, hopefully you'll be able to catch up. And if in case you can't catch up, then let me know so that I'll get on one-on-one with you and I'll explain you whichever things you need to understand. Okay, let's continue. So let's start with managing users. So this is a basic admin task that you guys will get when you start your project. So these tasks are like, okay, there's a new employee, you need to provide him access, or someone has left, you need to remove access to him, or you need to add some roles to any person or remove some roles to any person. So this would be your tasks. So you need to go to setup, go to users and roles, and manage users. So if you get an opportunity, like for example, let's say, okay, we need to add a role to this person, Krishna Kodamasimham. Okay, so in that case you need to go to that user record, currently is active, you need to add any role. So just click on edit, and all those you do in access. So under access you can add any role. So the main task that you will get is give access or remove access. So whenever you give access to a new person, or else let's try giving access to Funny. Let's see if we can give access to Funny. Funny, you there? You're on the call? Funny, you're on the call, right?
Yeah.
Okay, can you send us your email address on the chat? I'll try to create a user record so that everybody will see. You'll get to know how to create a user record. So this is how you add a role and remove a role. For example, there's a role, you can remove it. Just click on the role and remove it. And giving access is using this give access, and you need to provide a password. Only when you are giving access for the first time, you need to provide a password. Okay. Yeah, I got it. So let's try creating. Is a list and leave. So new employee. Okay, take it easy. Okay, Funny. Okay, and then your email is important. Okay, we have your email. And then are there any required fields? That's what we need to see every time. Okay, there's a required field subsidiary. Just select either. And then are there any required fields under here? Address, human resource, is there any required field? No, there's no, okay, this one. Okay, it's already selected. That's good. Okay. So when you're trying to create any form, like create a sales order, or create a customer, or create a vendor, or create an employee, whenever you're creating it manually, make sure you select all the required fields. Required fields are marked by an asterisk after the field label. So on the time tracking, there's nothing. The commission, there's nothing. Marketing, subscriptions, okay. So we go on the access, give access, and we do any password. let's do W caps E and C O N A. Okay. And then that should be enough. And then let's give admin role to Funny administrator. Okay. Alright. So this is how you create a role. You provide the details, then you say give access, you give any password, and also you can do this required password change on next login. Okay, so whenever he logs in, he can change the password. So Funny, the password is welcome123 W capital. Okay. W is capital, okay, with W capital. So I'm saving. Let's see if I can save this record or not. Illegal ID, please enter a name. Okay, it looks like there's a script on employee record. Okay, enter a name. Enter first name and last name for bill pay enabled employees. Wow. Okay, where is first name and last name fields? You guys see first name and last name. Okay, this might be first name and last. Funny, what's your last name? Can we get it from here? Yeah, just ping it. Or else we'll give you your last name. Funny NetSuite. Okay. M E L L A C H E R U P Q. Okay. So your PM. Okay, let's save. Will it save this time? I'm lucky enough. Yes. So Funny, we've created a user account for you. Just use this URL system.na1.netsuite.com, and your password should be welcome123 with W capital, and you'll have admin role. So it's done. So this is how you create a user role, and you can you'll get tasks like updating a, like you can even inactivate a user role. Let's try to inactivate any user role. When someone leaves, like when an employee leaves the company, most of times, not most of times, every time, we do inactivate the user. The user record should be inactivated. Let's inactivate someone. Sachin Tendulkar, I don't think he requires this account. Let's edit. So inactive, it should be under system information. Is it in system information? Yeah, okay. Just inactive and save. So these all you do on a employee record. You just make changes, provide access, add roles, remove roles. And if someone says, hey, reset my password, when you need to reset someone's password, let's try to reset someone's password. Prem, I'm going to reset your password since you've done mine. I'm returning the favor. The list. This Prem here. It's not visible. His account doesn't want to get reset. I'll find it this way. Okay, see. So whenever we need to reset password for someone, you need to edit the record. First, remove the access. When you need to reset password for someone, remove the access. But make sure you note down the roles, because when you're resetting password, if you don't remember the roles, when you come back to the record and give access, you need to provide the same roles, or else it's going to be a confusion. Like, the person will say, hey, I used to have this many roles, now I have only one role or two roles. I just asked you to reset my password, not to remove my roles. So whenever you are resetting password of somebody, edit the record, make a note of all the roles they currently have, and then remove this, give access, and save. Okay, so again you go back to the role. He doesn't have access currently. See, all the roles are gone. So now you give access and you give a password, say Prem is the same password, welcome 123. And I'm saying require password change on next login. And let's give him administrator. Prem, you can add the rest of the roles yourself. Save, let's see if it gives any message. No. So that's how you reset a password. First you remove the access and then you give back the access with a new password. And what else can we do? Okay, I have a meeting at 7, I didn't know about it. So let's see all this. Custom, there's nothing. Yeah, these are the only things that you'll be asked to do. Yeah, just providing access and adding and removing roles. Okay, so that's about managing users. And let's see next one, managing roles. Okay, so we've seen adding roles and removing roles to a user. Now we'll work directly on the roles itself. So in order to access roles, get on to setup, users roles, and manage roles. Here are the list of roles that your client or company possesses. So currently Honeycomb has all these roles. And your task would be like, okay, add a permission to a role, remove a permission to a role. That's it. Just those two things. Adding permissions and removing permissions. So let's get into a role. Shipping. So how does a role record looks like? This is how it looks like. Okay, it looks like this. The name, ID. Don't worry, you won't be creating roles. If in case you are creating roles, don't bother to give an ID. Because for the roles, it's better to leave it with the default ID. These are all you won't select, just subsidiary. Okay, this is the main thing. The main part of role record is the permissions. So under permissions, okay, this role, this particular role, what is this role? This is shipping role, okay. Whoever has shipping role, what permissions should they have? So these are all transactions. You can see find transaction. There's a bin transfer, okay. Okay, yesterday we came across bin, it's a bin transfer, okay. Purchase order, you can see item fulfillment, you can see sales order, you can see vendor returns, vendor return authorization. So these are all transactions. You can even have opportunity in all those. So for this shipping role, it has permissions to this transactions and what permissions it has. For example, item fulfillment, it has a full permission. Full permission means it can create, edit, update, delete, everything. And look at return authorization. It has only view permission, so it can't do anything. It can just view a return authorization. It cannot edit or create or delete. So on a role record, we have permissions to transactions. We have permissions to reports. So reports, again, I said reports are nothing but the ones created by business. So it's under here. New report or saved reports. So business creates reports and provides permission to particular roles to access the reports. So it's over here. You can come. You can do it on two ways, two sides. Like on the report itself, you can go select this role so that role person can get the access to that report. Or else you can come to the role itself and select here the permissions. Over here you can give complete, like full permission. Okay, and lists, these are custom lists and even some standard lists. So yeah, vendors is standard list. So mostly so these are all standard lists. So you can give permission to a role, like can on the vendors, you can view the, see this shipping role can view vendors but cannot create a vendor, or it can cannot delete a vendor, or even it cannot update a vendor. So it's for the lists, permissions on lists. And the permissions on setup too, okay? Like user access tokens, login using access tokens, access token management. You might think, what are all these? Don't worry, need not bother about all those. If you want to know what is access token management, just go to help and click. There are a whole lot of things within NetSuite, which you will, even after working for 10 years on NetSuite, you may not know many things that are present in NetSuite. So don't worry about it. You need to know what you work on, like what are the things that you need to work and what are the things that you have worked on. The basic process and how does the process work, how you can customize your process. That's it. Those are the things you need to know. So under roles, these are permissions, transaction permissions, report permission, list permissions, setup permissions, and even custom records. See, yesterday we've seen custom records. When we create custom records, we can even provide permission to the custom record on a role. You can come to the role and select the custom record. Let's do it. Yesterday we created a custom record, right? What was that? Was it Abbas or you could test, I guess, yeah. Started with test. It's not available. Or maybe, let's see why it's not available here. Customization, custom records. And then, okay, so this is the one we created yesterday. Test record, okay, test NetSuite training, let's see. Requires custom record enters permission. Use permission list. Okay, this is the thing. On the custom record, if you say use permission list and save, you have chosen to use permission list but have not defined any roles under permission subtype. Please specify permissions for this custom record type or choose another access type and click save. Okay, so, okay, when you say use permission list, you need to get into permissions and provide roles here. Yeah, sir, you need to select from here itself. Like, okay, shipping, add, so only shipping role can see it. Save it. And go to shipping role, say cancel, do refresh. Hopefully, it should be visible here. Yeah, test NetSuite training, see? And here it's none, there's no permission. So you can do edit. Let's see what permissions can we give. Where is it? Custom record. Test NetSuite training. Okay, you can give full permission. Or you can just give create permission. Okay, that's it. So it's like this. So what are all these access types? First one is requires custom record enters permission to indicate that only users logging in with the role with permission granted to custom record type can access it. You choose use permission list to grant access to the custom record type according to the permission setup on the permission subtype of this page. Okay. Choose no permission required to make access to the custom record type public. Okay, so it should have been in the first value. Then we should have been able to select it, but I don't know why, for some reason we couldn't find it. And normally if you select the first option, which is this required custom record enters permission, then you go to a role, you go to any role under custom record, you should be able to select that custom record and provide access to it. Anyhow, so these are permissions to all transaction reports, lists, setup and custom records. Apart from this, there are also forms, so you can specify which form should be enabled for these roles. You can even disable a form for this role. So you can see all the forms are enabled currently. All the transaction forms are enabled. So if you want, you might get a requirement saying, hey, this particular form, this particular role should not have access to it. So just come to the role, edit the role, get into forms. And which form is that? Is it a transaction form or any CRM form? Any item form or any custom record form, select it and remove the access, like remove the enable or just disable it. And what else we have? Standard searches and custom record. Let's see what we have here in the custom record. Yeah, we have all the custom records. So yeah, I guess you can even find our custom record. Yeah, test NetSuite training. So you can can create. So this role, purchasing role, can create a search on this custom record. That's the permission we give. And then users. So you get to see who all have this role in their user record. So currently Sam Smith is a person. He's the only one who has purchasing role under him, assigned to him. But in order to assign role, you need to get into that employee record. You should not come here and try to add. See, there's no way you can add a person here. So you need to get to the user record and then add a role to it. Then these are just preferences, dashboard, translation, and history. You do not bother about all this. Yeah, history is important. You can see what all have changes have been done on this role. So the tasks that you get on the role are just adding or removing permissions. Permissions and enabling, disabling forms or searches, or you won't do anything with users. Only if you want to see, okay, there's a particular role, I want to know who all has this role, then you need to come to the role, get inside users tab, and you can see the list of users who has that role assigned to them. So this is about roles, and let's see what else we have. So we have file cabinet, email templates. Okay, what is file cabinet, what are email templates? Okay, under documents you can see files and file cabinet. So file cabinet is a place where we store all our documents. I guess we went through this one while doing the UI walkthrough, so I guess you all might remember it. So under documents, under files, we have file cabinet, and on file cabinet you store everything, like it's your hard drive. But make sure you don't store anything which is more than 5 MB size. So any file more than 5 MB, if you store, you can't access it from scripts, or you can't do anything. You can certainly store a file more than 5 MB, but you'll just store it, but you can't do anything with it. You can't access it from any transaction. You can't create a field. For example, if you create your own picture which is more than 5 MB, and you go to your employee record, you create a field called picture, add picture, and you try to access your picture, you can't if it's more than 5 MB. So make sure it should be less than 5 MB. So let's see what are there in the file cabinet of Honeycomb. So app packages, assembly instructions, Celigo, these all come from bundles. Okay, within file cabinet we also have suite scripts. So what is suite scripts? In the suite scripts folder we have all the scripts. So as a developer, when you'll be creating scripts, all your script files will be stored in suite script folder, that is in file cabinet. So documents, files, file cabinet. Inside file cabinet you'll have a suite script folder, and that's where all your scripts will be stored by default. And instead of going to documents, files, file cabinet, and then looking for the suite script folder, it's directly available here. So files and suite script, it comes to the same page. So, and you can see what are the attachments you received and what are attachments sent. So these three are the attachments that this Honeycomb account has received from external source. And let's see what are the attachments that we've sent from this Honeycomb instance. Oh good, Rakesh has done something, or he might have just created a folder here. Okay, good, he tried to send something. Okay, then what else we have? Images. You can store all your images here. These are all images stored in Honeycomb or NetSuite instance. Whenever you have time, just look at it and see what's there. Okay, that's about files. So inside the files, we have all this file cabinet and all those things. Then we have templates. So inside templates, the main thing you'll be working on is the email templates. And trust me, fax templates, e-letter templates, PDF templates, you won't be working on this. Marketing, template files, web store email templates. The only thing you'll be working on is email templates, because this is important. So whenever you're sending, we are sending emails from NetSuite to customers or vendors, we'll be using a template. Actually, I guess I've told you guys about this too. So why do you need an email template? You'll be sending same kind of data to multiple customers. So it doesn't make sense if you keep on typing the same set of paragraph, same paragraph each and every time, similar looking paragraph. So that's why we create email templates, which are just automatic. And the only things that change on a email are the information of sales order. Like if you're sending email to a customer regarding fulfillment, okay, the fulfillment number or the sales order from which the fulfillment has been created. So those kinds of things which we access from the transactions, those would be the only changes, and rest all data would be the same. Rest all message would be the same. So that's why we use email templates. Let's see if there are any email templates. I don't see any email templates here. This one custom email template, RBK template. Let's see, what is this? Please find all details enclosed in this email. Okay, good. So you can send this to every customer. But yeah, if you want to put any details, then you edit this. Okay, good. So here you can enter anything enclosed in this email and select anything like field type. Okay, from where you want to go to a transaction. Okay, good. Transaction. So insert field. Okay, on transactions, these are all your fields. You said order details, right? Let's see if you can give any sales order. So you can give sales order account type. So these are all the transaction fields that are currently available. So you can use any field like created date. So this is how it shows. Dollar sign and then the path transaction.date created is the internal ID of that date created field and in closed brackets. So this is about email templates. This is how you create. You can type whatever data, whatever message you want, which would be standard, constant to every customer. And then you select the fields, which will be changing from customer to customer based upon the fields that are on the transaction. So guys, I guess today it will be short. I didn't notice that I had a meeting at 7. So I need to get on the other call. Hopefully today is Thursday, right? So tomorrow is Friday. Okay. So tomorrow we should be completing our admin part of training. So we are just left with suite bundler, dashboard, KPIs, and that's it. NetSuite support and help answers, there's nothing much. I'll show you how to get support from NetSuite and how to search for any questions in help or in suite answers. Okay, guys. Sorry, it's been a short session today. So we'll continue from tomorrow. Meanwhile, I'll work on editing the recordings and sending to send it to you guys. Okay, guys. Thanks. Have a good night.